Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Astroneer. My name is Spartan Elite 43, and we are in episode number 4. Now, if you remember, in the last episode, we made a rover. We climbed that mountain, which is actually a lot smaller than the rest of the mountains, apparently. And we started to build a tunnel. So, what we're going to do today is we're going to complete our tunnel. We're going to go in and try to come up with some sort of better, more livable space rather than being right out in the open where heat-seeking boulders in a sandstorm can kill us. And then I'm going to figure out what the heck my robotic arm slash 3D printer slash not sure exactly what exactly it's doing is doing to my rover. Come on. Oh, I hope it's not broken. I really hope it's not. I worked hard for this rover. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to have to do here. Let's click on it. Can we? Yep, can't click on it. Oh, it's freaking out. Apparently, you got to make it freak out before it'll do what it needs to do. Alright, so, what do we have in our backpack? Because we have a lot of resin in our backpack. I don't remember exactly what we make out of resin. Apparently, nothing in our backpack is made out of resin. I think it's mostly for all of this extra stuff, which we are going to need to put 2 resin on there, because we need this to be our 3D printer eventually. And then I think once I get over to that side and we get this whole thing. Do I have copper on me? No, I don't. Oh well. What I will do though is put some of this resin. Stop pulling out the gun. Put the resin on the thing. And then put some more resin on this side. So that I can clear as much space in my backpack as I can. And that reminds me, I could have changed this to a truck. Of course you need a bunch of aluminum for the truck, apparently. So that'll be for another episode. But we have a rover, and we have an excellent rover. So let's take one of our solar panels and put on the rover. Maybe even both of them. Let's get really daring. So that it can charge itself while I'm out. Because can you think of a better way to do things than have a self-sustaining rover? Like, that sounds amazing to me. Get in the rover. Let's go. Whee! Now, trying to make the rover do little things like park is a pain, but actually driving it out in the open really isn't bad. I'm gonna get out here, and I'm gonna get my gun out, and we're gonna go back to that, I believe? Yes. And that will give me quite the little bridge. Alright, if that's in, that's out. That must be the flattening tool. Am I right? Nope, I'm wrong. Okay. Quit trying to think ahead. You know nothing, Jon Snow. You know nothing. That's what I get for trying to think I'm smart. Alright. Back in the truck. Whee! Whoa. Always remember, no matter what you're doing, no matter which way you're looking, if you press forward looking at anything, you will drive to it. That was what was goofing me up the last time. I was trying to park by trying to use reverse and stuff, when all I needed to do was point at it and press forward. I'm not joking. Look. Woo! No, 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 no. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, I crashed. Who crashes their rover? Good Lord. Apparently, I do. And I'm not going to be able to get that. Great. Good job, Spartan. Now your rover's stuck. It's a good thing you got this giant terraforming thing that you can make a good semi-ramp to drive up, I guess. Anyway, back in the rover. Can I get up this? Yes, that would be a... Holy moly! I got ejected. That was awesome. Alright. So let's go back in here. Oh, okay, so it's connected through the ground somehow. Not sure exactly how that works, but I'm not going to complain. So there we go. And then we'll put another one down here. Actually, we won't. Let's go ahead and pull our gun out. Turn this direction. Pull the gun out. Thank you. And suck away everything until we get through to the other side. Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side. No, not a whole lot of Stones fans. Look at that! You guys thought I couldn't do it. You guys didn't believe in me. I saw you. I heard you. You guys were doubting me the entire time. You were like, he's just gonna drill into the mountain. Nope. I knew what I was doing all alone. Almost. Somewhat. Maybe not. Alright, you caught me. But it worked. It worked. That's what matters. Oh, now if I can only turn myself around and not get sick doing it. Oh, okay. Oh, God. Oh, God. Whoa. Cameras do not like confined spaces, apparently. I don't even care that it's not on the floor. I'm just trying not to, like, screw this up. Get that there. Put this one here. It's still connected. Yay! Look at this. Now, this looks like a compound. Easily defendable from multiple sides. Unless, of course, they climb over the mountain, in which case I'm screwed. But it's a good idea. What's over here? This is where ADD kicks in, guys. Like, you can't help it. That's why these games are so amazing. Now, I'm not a PS4 guy, so I don't get to play games like No Man's Sky, even though it looked cool and everybody hated it. It looked cool to me. So this is why I wanted to try this game out. It's a very fun and gratifying game to play. It really is. Like, you start playing it and you can't help yourself. You'll be doing one thing, set goals for yourself, and the next thing you know, you're completely across the map going, hey, look, a butterfly. Or, you know, you just get distracted by everything. You can't help it. The world is so beautiful. Now, can I get the rover through here, or do I need to make my tunnel bigger? That'll be the question. This rover is a rock-crawling monster. Look at that. That's what I'm talking about right there. And the solar panels automatically detect where the sun is, so they get optimal energy. So I can essentially drive this as long as I want, with the exception that I have a limited amount of oxygen. And no real way to see... Okay, I guess I can see it through there. But, yeah. So... Now we have all this nice little area that we can build a base in, possibly. But I've got my rover in here, and I don't want to do it. So we completed our tunnel. That was the goal. So now our tunnel is complete, even though our rover... Look at this rover. This rover is a mountain-climbing goat. Don't let it lie to you. It's not a rover at all. It's a goat. And I just realized something that's really cool that you guys may not have noticed. The sun is directional. When I'm inside the valley between the mountains, the sun goes away. Whoa! Airborne. That was awesome. Dude, this thing is a monster. But anyway, so when I'm in the valleys, the sun goes away. But the sun's still up, so I can actually go to... Whoa. Oh yeah, that's the top of my tunnel. So... Let's go. Now, we are going to run out of power because of the sun going down. But that's okay. You're supposed to run out of power. Whoa! We about ran it. There's a ditch everywhere. It's like a river used to run through here. Wonder if there was water. If there was water, there was probably... Whoa! Oh, good lord. Okay. We're going over the river and through the woods. Yeah, you like that. Come on. No. Whoa! No, no, no. Get out of the hole. I forgot. That was my resin hole. Forgot about that. Do-do-do. I wonder how big this planet is. Can I, like, drive across the planet? Like, that would... Whoa! Holy cave, Batman. What's in there? I'm out of power. What happens when I run out of power? Exactly what you would think would happen when you run out of power. You're out of power. You can't do anything. That's unfortunate, because I'm a long ways away and probably don't have a whole lot of oxygen. No, actually, I have plenty of oxygen. Does that mean what I think it means? Hey, you probably would have a little bit of power if you did turn the lights off. Or how about this? How do I have lights on if I have no power? I'm guessing that those blue marks in the center of this rover is one giant oxygen tank that fills up when it's on its umbilical cord. So that's nifty, because I would essentially have no oxygen right now because I'm out of power. But as you can see, I'm full oxygen. I wonder if that actually drains away after a while. It would be cool if it did. Like, if you could see the stuff going down. But I have a feeling that it's either a glitch or the game made it that way. So when you're on your rover, you don't use oxygen out of your backpack. Which is nifty. I mean, if it stores battery power, it should be able to store some oxygen, right? So that you have your basic necessities. The bad news is, I'm in the middle of nowhere. It's nighttime, and I have no power. And I slid to the bottom of this, so that means until the sun gets kind of high, I'm not going to have any power. But, hopefully, it looks like the sun may be getting... Ooh, look at that. There's either a giant chunk missing out of that planet, or... Yeah, it's just glitched. Look, if you look there, there's a giant chunk missing. If you look there, it's perfectly whole. But if you look up too long, it looks like you're moving instead of the planet. Actually, I guess it would be you moving. Because the planet I'm on is rotating. What is this? Like, the missing chunk of the planet is over there. That is weird. Cool, but weird. I could literally look at that all day. That is awesome. I don't know exactly what causes that glitch, but that's something else. I just hope that those aren't going to crash into us, because it looks like it's getting awfully close. Wouldn't that be something? I could be the first YouTuber to die from an interspace collision. That would be ridiculous. It does look like it's about to crash into the planet, though. I wish I had some power so I could go check it out. I'd chase it down. Look at that. Like, it's a giant watermelon. A weird-looking watermelon. Kind of reversed, but a giant watermelon. Oh, I'm such a dork. I can't help it. I really wish I was out there right now. So I could see how cool this is. The sun's coming up, which means I'm going to get power soon. Maybe if I can get out, I can move it. Can I? Click. No, no, not the seat. I don't want to take the seat. Yeah, I don't think so. Hey, we're getting power. Good. Let's drive out of this hole. Get all the power. Look how quick my power goes up with two solar panels on the back. We could drive this thing all day. Let's go exploring. That could never go wrong, right? Wonder how fast this thing can go. I'd say that's about it. What is that? Is that power? That is power. That's interesting. It's a resin fountain. Oh, apparently the resin fountain has run dry. Well, that was interesting. There's all kinds of stuff on this planet. Hey, that looks like a bigger mountain. That looks like a bigger cave. What is that? A mountain with a hole in it. That could never go wrong, right? Can I climb it? The answer would be no. Maybe I can climb this side. This looks promising. Go, little rover, go! Oh, oh, we crashed. So I promised you we'd go exploring, and we're about to climb a mountain in a rover. I'm sure nobody's done that before. And this one has a polar ice cap. Come on, rover. You're gonna get to the top. Look down. Don't look down. Oh, I'm looking down. Don't look down. Oh no, I wrecked. No. Where'd my rover go? Put the gun away. Oh no, rover! Rover, don't do it! It's not worth it! Oh, I'm hurting myself chasing my rover down a friggin' cliff. Oh, good lord. You gotta be careful in this game. Everything's trying to kill you. Alright, we made it to the bottom. Where's my rover? I gotta get back in my rover. Alright, let's get out of this hole. We gotta get home before night. Man, I gotta quit wrecking. Hey, at least I can flip it back over. Couldn't push it out of a hole, but I can flip it over. Alright, at least they put a home icon on the screen. Otherwise, I would be completely lost. Whee! So we went a long ways from home, guys. A long way. So long, in fact, that I'm back to using power again. Oh! There's the river. Yep, that's the river. Good news is this river ends right at our base. It's like a driveway, guys. Bloop. And the best part is, I know that all I gotta do is drive up here, stop, get out, turn around, put the gun away, and Hibooski! Now, those solar panels are also hooked up to the base. So, it's a multi-purpose vehicle. Alright. So, the next thing I need to do is I need to find some copper. I really do. And I don't know where I'm going to find copper, but I'm thinking it's probably in that cave up there. Because everybody knows that the rarer the material, the deeper it is, usually. So we're going to go jump off this cave. Whee! God, I love the fact that you're in a vehicle, you don't have falling damage. And the lights are much brighter. Oh, what is that? Alright, this is the point at which my inner crocodile hunter says, I'm going to poke it with a stick. It's nasty! What? I'm guessing I just died. Apparently, whatever that thing was, it was deadly. Of course it was, because everything in this game is trying to kill you. Now, the question is, how long is it deadly? Do I have enough time to go down there and collect it? Or is it going to kill me again? These are the questions we must ask. I don't know what this thing is, but it looks deadly, and it is. And I wonder if I can't snap it to this. Let's pull one of you off, just real quick. Now let's get in here. I also realized another interesting fact. Great. Just what I needed, a sandstorm. I have basically no power. I'm in a sandstorm. Rocks are about to start pelting me. Inside the cave again. Actually, I can't park this in the cave, because if I park it in the cave, I won't have any power. So I have no choice. I'm out of power. That's bad. Good news is, I'm below ground, so I should be okay from the sandstorm and its heat-seeking boulders. Alright, I need to get down here and collect my body. I got a bunch of stuff on me. Hey, that's power. I can use the power on the thingy-majig. Can I put it in my backpack? I can. Good. And let's grab the hairy ball. That's very deadly. Don't touch yourself with it. That's preferable. And just don't mind that. Oh, if it would quit zooming into my face, that would be preferable. I don't know what I gotta do to get this thing up there, but I'm gonna do it. Somebody didn't think this through. I'm not gonna mention any names because that would be rude. But obviously, somebody did not think this bridge through. Which is easier? Let's just cut that down just a hair. Alright, that should be good. Alright, now. Run back to base before this thing kills you again. I'm sorry I haven't been very talkative here in the last couple minutes, but I've had to concentrate a little bit. I'm sure you guys will understand. That thing is hideous. It's even worse in the daylight. And give me something good, guys. Come on. Give me something good. Habitat? Well, that sounds useful. That sounds really useful, actually. Now, if only I could find some copper. Ouch. Probably should stop dropping on top of stuff. Alright, let's go this way, go around this way, go over the hole, deep down in. Hey, look, there's. What is. Malachite? What? Copper ore! You know what that means, guys. We found it, I told you. I told you. What is that? Unknown. Yeah. Last time I went to something that was unknown, it killed me. So no thank you, game. I learned my lesson at least a little bit. So that said copper ore. Malachite is copper ore. And if I remember correctly, there's a machine called the smelter. Smelter, copper ore, makes copper. That's just a guess, but it sounds promising. Yeah. Let's go into backpack and drop some of this resin. No, because I'm gonna need that. I'm gonna need that for the smelter. I'm also gonna need compound for the smelter. Alright, well, you wait right there. We'll be back. I know where you are at. Ish. Oh, about fell in the hole. That would have been bad. Oh, don't want to crash into that. That'll probably kill me. But, really? This thing can climb mountains, but apparently can't climb over that. And if you go over, like, 20 degrees, it'll drop you. That's always nice. Dagnabbit. I forgot again that you drive in the direction you're looking, so just press forward and look the direction you want to go. It's pretty simple. So simple a caveman can do it. Just not me. There we go. Look at that. Professional driver coming through. Coming through. Look at this drifting skill. Terrible. Terrible. Alright, let's back into it. Nope, 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 nope. Pull forward. Straight into it. Doesn't have to be perfect. Thank you. Get out. Look. Click. It didn't do it. Look. Click. Thank you. Alright. Look at me. We are starting to get some stuff done. Now, I know that there were compound over there. And I'm going to have to use the rover to get there. But we've made some headway. We found some very precious materials. And we're going to use this not to make a printer. No, 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 no. Not a printer. Because we need copper for a printer. So what we're going to make is instead a smelter. Yeah, smelter it is. Now, I don't have any compound on me, so we can't make the smelter right now. But I think this is a good place to end this episode. We climbed mountains. We went exploring. We found caves. We came. We saw. We conquered. We got killed by yet another new thing. I'm going to find every way to die in this game, I think. But anyway, if you like what I'm doing, punch that like button. Leave a comment below. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And as always, I will see you in the next video.